Before we dive into this feature, a big thanks to Skillshare for sponsoring Keep Productive this month. Skillshare is an online learning community for creators with more than 25,000 classes. You can get hold of a premium membership, which gives you unlimited access to those classes for less than $10 a month. You can join over 7 million creators learning on Skillshare, and you will get a 2-month free trial in the description below. I highly recommend Skillshare. I create classes on there myself, but I would recommend checking out Thomas Frank's latest one on productivity systems, as well as Lindsay Holmes's one on productivity with Evernote, especially if you're looking to deep dive into that tool. And if you do have an extra moment, I'd check out Productivity Habits That Stick with the legend Mike Vardy. Anyway, guys, thanks so much, and thanks to Skillshare for sponsoring this video. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here, and it's the first video back from my little getaway. I'm just going to be diving into today how we used Evernote for our wedding. And I want to guide you around the account or the notebook that we used. As you can imagine, I still use Evernote as my active sort of document scanner and also just general toolkit for finding all the useful information, especially when I travel. Notion's not got travel line access offline, and also just useful stuff, anything from finance to government documents to things like that, that I just want to be able to save. It sounded like that was a bit more important. I mean, like election stuff and you know, bank stuff, I guess. Not necessarily like government information. I make this sound proper weird. Okay, so I've got a wedding notebook here that we've got in archive. So I use the typical structure that Tiago Forte promotes, which is the 4 core projects. I'll include his link to his course in the description below because it's such a great course. So this is in archives area. And that's actually helped me to organize everything, especially when the wedding has been finished. So as you can see here, we started planning on Saturday, 20th of August. I was actually using Notion at the time. I was probably a month or two into using Notion, but I wasn't fully confident in the platform in actually committing to planning our wedding in it. So I used Evernote, and actually was something that my wife was pretty comfortable using. And it looks like we started pretty late in the evening, and we started planning the event venues. So we started very simply by creating this list of event venues with emails and questions. And I would say that's where you started, because we just checked in every single month, really, in terms of like planning the core things and getting the date nailed down. Now, the second big note that we used was this one, which was called the overview wedding planning. And we were constantly just sort of tweaking this one, at least for a couple of days until we moved to another one. But this was a way for us literally just to list down everything that we were thinking of in our brain and just put it down, and actually just general pricing for all of that sort of stuff. Now, as you can imagine, you know, we were getting married 2 years after that, so we had plenty of time. So what we wanted to do is basically begin sort of creating a guest list. So we created this really simple guest list that got us started. Now, as time goes on even further, we created a stationery list, very, very simple, as you can see, and we'll get to the more complex lists a little up there, because I think our use got even better. We also were saving I Spy missions for the wedding day, and also invitation design. This was like something that we were just saving, the two different designs that we had, and we were preparing for everything like that. Now, we were also saving emails up here. So we were saving emails from Airbnb about, you know, information about the hotel and where we were staying at, etc. And then we were also saving inspiration. So we had cake details and sort of themes like that. Now, I will share with you a little bit of how it got more complex in terms of our Evernote use. So here we had something called the logistics of the town hall. So we were getting married in the town hall. So what we did is we had like this what to do list and different areas. So we had like a general what to do, start adding the welcome signs, seating, tables, and we had these little checklists here. So we were going down on the day and sort of checking them off. What we need to include in the suite table, guest table, food table, cake table. And we also had this sort of, we wrote out on an A3 sort of piece of paper with how the structure of the room would look, with our ideal sort of outline. So we drew that on A3, we scanned that in using the app, and what we did later is we actually modified this. So if I go to the town hall layout, actually that's not the one I was thinking of. If I scroll up and try and find it, town hall layout details, maybe it was. So there we go. We had sort of like all of the people we were inviting and basically started to plot them out on tables. So this was really handy, and we actually used, it wasn't Notability, it was the scannable app to actually modify this, and actually used the editor on the PDF annotation online to edit this one, which is really, really helpful. So going back to this logistics of the town hall, this was actually a really useful thing to send around to family and actually get people checked. So what check that we were doing it right. So we copied this shareable link and we sent it to family, and they would say, you know, you need to add tablecloths, you need to add to iSpy games, etc. But this was a good starting point, definitely when it was in terms of 6 months in advance too. Now, you've probably been noticing here things that I won't be necessarily clicking into is like completed forms. So we had to fill out a lot of forms for the wedding, including like deposits, forms, and you know, receipts and things like that. And we were just saving them as PDFs into the Evernote account, which is really helpful. And we also had these smaller things as well. So we would create like things to do lists. And this would just be simply creating a table and listing the per person things we need to ask them and giving a bit of a status on these. Now, you probably could use a project manager for this, but actually we found it pretty simple to do this sort of thing, and actually just every single month at least go into it and refresh it. Now, also we had the receipts, but we also used this thing called a wedding pipeline. Now, we had all the different types of payments up here, when we would be paying them, because as you can imagine, a wedding is pretty stressful when it comes to payments. Payments coming out all over the place, people asking you for money. We had the date and time, so the month and what it was included, the amount and whether it was paid or not, and we'd green select them off. So all you have to do that is, it was a lot easier. It's a lot easier now to do that, but all you have to do is change the cell background. And then we had like the activities, like all of the stuff, how much we'd paid so far to pay and updating it there, and then including a couple of PDFs. So this was like the pipeline in terms of like being able to see everything. So actually having everything in one place in terms of finance and updates was quite helpful. Now, we also had, you know, readings and hymns and things like that. So we were able to sort of tag all this in there and be able to highlight the hymns that we wanted for our wedding. We were getting married in church, so that's why we had to select hymns. And even everything from the stag do was organized in here. So we would capture the receipts and who's paid the stag do taxis and things like that. Now, I will show you the wedding inventory. So we actually had like two bases, because we had my house and Becca's house, and we were literally just logging what we had bought already and what they look like, just to confirm that we had them, because we were sort of spreading everything out across the sort of different areas. So we had to take these photos with them, and we had another one for Becca's house too. So it was quite handy to have like an inventory of what we got. Now, there wasn't really any sort of one note that would organize the whole thing, but it actually was really, really helpful to have this. Now, we actually had a cheat sheet as well. So what I did is I actually just, I did something that I know many people were probably like, well, why did you do that? I actually wrote out everything in a Bear document. Bear Notes is a competitor to Evernote, which I was using at the time, and I was really liking it because it was quite nice, and visually it was quite handy. So what we had here is the wedding day, we had a cheat sheet. So we wrote this out inside of Bear. We downloaded it in a PDF format and we uploaded it to Evernote and then shared it out using the link. And what was really helpful was we had this sort of cheat sheet, like of all questions that we listed, and you know, like literally everything, so that we made sure that we didn't screw up. And we literally had timings and logistics, and these were for people. We just printed out like a couple of these so that our family would have them, And they were just a general, just back of the pocket things. If you're in a bit of a sort of worry, then you could, you know, basically go to it. Now, one of the things that I also did was plan my wedding speech inside of Evernote. And I wrote this in my head like 6 months before, but actually just wrote down Evernote the month before the wedding. And actually, it was really nice to have this. And I'm really appreciative that I've got this, not in physical format, but I've got this in Evernote. And it was actually, it's really sort of really a big part of my Evernote experience. I think that's sort of why I always have a really good sort of relationship with the applications, because I have used it for some of the most important moments of my life to some extent. So we also did a wedding day timeline, and this is one that I mentioned, I think, at the start. So in terms of Thursday, like the days before, what we were packing up, when we needed to do stuff, it was really fairly well coordinated. We would modify this and make sure that it was really organized the best that we could, even down to the wake-up time, so that we all had just a general plan of what was happening in the service. So that was pretty much my use. I wanted to do this video with Becca, but I'm sure we'll probably do like a productivity related video about weddings and how we went about organizing it. But in terms of like our Evernote use, this is how we got on with it. Now, what I would say to those people looking to plan is maybe go with tables, because we discovered at the start that tables were the best way to organize, and we found out later. And you may also notice that there were sort of some really random stuff like stationery lists, all that. And we began combining more of the only notes we were creating, just so that we had a bit of an easier base to find everything. So guys, that was how I was using, well, we were using the wedding and organizing it through Evernote. We recommend using it. If I had to do it again now when I was restarting it, then I'd probably organize it through Notion, but only because of the way that the databases work. And I know that Notion is probably going to be coming out with a timeline function soon, so that would make it a lot easier in terms of logistics. Plus, it would look a lot more attractive. In my opinion, Evernote was very static and still is very static. And it's just something that you might not appeal to. But anyway, guys, I hope you found this video useful. Please do let me know in the comments whether you managed to use Evernote for a big occasion, how you found it, and what you would like to improve, or what you know, what tips you would like to have for other people. Please do let me know in the comments whether this video was useful, because maybe I'll do some more of them. But again, I haven't done an Evernote video for a while, so maybe it was useful or maybe it wasn't. Just let me know. Thumbs up if you did. Anyway, guys, a big thank you. Make sure to subscribe, and I'll see you guys in a future video. Cheers, everyone.